Hi, this is Tokyo Wind. Today, I'll talk about the four candidates for Japan's next prime minister. On the 28th of September, the leader of the Liberal Democratic Party will be elected, and that leader will become the next prime minister. So let's take a look at the candidates. Number 1, Sanae Takaichi.She is often described as right-wing. She said the Japanese government statement apologizing for war crimes during World War II should be changed. In Japan, there are some people who believe that during World War II, Japan didn't invade Asian countries, but tried to liberate them from the white supremacist world.Therefore, what she said has a lot of support from them. On the internet, there is a picture of Sanae Takaichi and the leader of a Japanese neo-Nazi group. And she wrote a recommendation for a book, which was positive about the political strategies of Adolf Hitler. She wrote, "The key to victory is a strong will, with love and dreams for your country in your heart.Young people, let's take up the challenge. Anyway, the biggest problem is that she has a huge following among some Japanese people. Number 2, Taro Kono. He was a supporter of Donald Trump, and he is known as a Japanese Trump. He dismisses news reports against him as fake news.And blocks Twitter accounts that are critical of him. As a minister, he is in charge of vaccination. One day, he tweeted in English, "Vaccination in Japan, not bad, isn't it?" Along with a graph. That graph ranked Japan as number one in the world for COVID-19 vaccinations per 100 people. However, this graph is misleading, becauseJapan had very slow vaccine distribution and was not widely available to civilians. Then, Taro Kono was criticized by many people who said, "Are you kidding me? Or are you not embarrassed?" In Japan, the former Prime Minister Shinzo Abe is suspected of stealing people's money. However, the scandal is still unresolved, and Taro Kono said thatThere was no need to investigate. Why do you think he said that? Number 3, Seiko Noda. Her husband is a former Japanese mafia. This is a fact recognized by the court. That's it. Number 4, Fumio Kishida. He is determined to amend the constitution of Japan.And to introduce the national emergency clause into it. If this is introduced, it will allow the government to make laws that deprive people of their human rights. The prime minister will be able to take people's property and put people who criticize the government in jail without trial. This resembles Nazis' enabling act. In a country,where the scandal of the former prime minister allegedly stealing the people's money has never been resolved, what would happen if such a clause was introduced? These four people are the candidates for Japan's next prime minister. Japan will have changed prime ministers twice since the COVID-19 pandemic. By the way, which dog do you like best? Let me know in the comment section.And see you in the next video. Goodbye.